We're playing the Ballers theme. Listen to that, except we can't play all the words on the Ballers theme. The fantastic Omar Miller is here. But here's how savvy Omar is. He's got about 85 other things going on. We'll get to in a second. Is he was telling us a story, and then he paused it himself and said, let's save it for the air.
Oh, yes, he did.
So here we go.
Yeah.
The Ballers rap party.
Yeah.
Was like wild like Ballers or not really?
No.
Okay.
Oh. Don't disappoint us.
It was a little less spectacular than you would have expected. We had it at a great place here. We had it at Poppy, a huge club here.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And then people are working. Dwayne's the busiest guy in the world.
I always envisioned Dwayne, frankly, parachuting into Ballers.
Happens on set. Doesn't happen at the party.
Right.
They pay him to do that.
Usually
just walks in if he's not being paid.
Were you guys a really good show? And, you know, the final arc for you was fantastic. Coach of the Rams.
They put some meat on the bone.
Right.
Great. Yeah, the GM for the Rams. And wait till you see what happens. We only have 2 episodes left. And, if you watch, hopefully it doesn't spoil anything, but if you watch, Charles is having some health problems, a lot of stress in the job. So, the team comes together.
How did you like playing a coach? And did you model it after a coach that you've
seen? I played sports all through high school and then after that. And I was around a lot of coaches. This I modeled after a few of the guys that I studied that had retired and that were lost. There's a really serious detachment that takes place for people that are used to being cheered for and that have gotten to this level in life.
Yeah.
To get to the level of the NFL, you've done this your whole life. You've been great at this your whole life. Then when you leave it, when it's taken from you, it's a whole nother animal. Wow. The guys, it's something that they really, it's almost like post-traumatic stress for them to have to step away. They have to find something to substitute that.
By the way, this is a cautionary tale for the four of us.
Right.
This occupation.
This is absolutely similar to being a highly paid NFL player. He's the guy who's going to tell us
exactly what it is. All right, we're only going to show a snippet of this. KTLA's own Megan Tellis actually featured. Do it as a
really?
VO. Don't turn the sound up, but just run the tape. She plays a reporter. And come out of it now.
At a gentleman's club.
At a gentleman's club. Okay. She's working for Channel 37. Was her performance inspiring?
Up to code.
Up to code. Yeah. And that's all you can ask is that she's up to code.
She raised her game. She came. She fit right in.
Right. And then the one other thing that I thought was really cool is all the new Rams facilities. You're in.
Yeah.
So what's it like?
Yes.
None of us have seen it.
8th wonder of the world. You guys are going to, even in its shell form, it's better than the Coliseum is now.
Right.
Okay.
How about that?
I've heard that. I've heard people say it's absolutely amazing.
We were shooting there and, there was a lot of regulations to even be there for insurance purposes and whatnot. It's vast.
Yeah.
It would take you 5 to 10 minutes in a shuttle ride to get to the actual stadium.
Wow.
Right.
Yeah, it's huge.
Oh, wow. Looking forward to that. Okay. Should we show the Ballers clip? Let's do that. Here's, of course, the show we've been talking about. Watch.
What's wrong with you, Charles? Stressing out about your deal?
Trying not to stress out about anything. Doctor told me to find a place that resonates with me.
Resonates?
Yeah. Help keep my cortisol levels down.
Okay, I'll bite, Charles. What exactly does elevated cortisol cause?
Well, according to WebMD, muscle weakness, spasms, severe irritability, extreme fatigue, constipation, headaches, anxiety, inflammation, basically it makes you die faster.
Mark has all those symptoms.
You got to lower that cortisol, brother.
Yeah.
Oh. There we go.
Fabulous actor in that scene with me. I got to work with him the last 3 years. Kevin Durand. He's wonderful.
He's really good, and the dynamic between you is good.
Yeah, and one of the things that was great, and one of the things great about Ballers in general, is I get to act with other big guys.
Right, you don't feel little.
Yeah. Kevin is like 6'6".
Right.
Wow.
Dwayne is 6'4".
Right. Yeah.
I'm 6'5", 6'6". Like it makes a difference. It's a trippy thing because you get to a certain height and you outgrow the world.
Weird.
There you go.
Physically,
we
don't fit
know.
In cars.
You know what?
Jessica's, you don't fit on planes.
Jessica's never had this problem. really, really quick because they're totally pushing us along. Unicorn, new show on CBS.
Yes. This show is fantastic. It airs tonight, 8:30 on CBS. I'm really proud of this thing. It stars Walton Goggins, myself, Rob Corddry, who's also on Ballers. Michaela Watkins, Mylon Robinson. We have a great cast, and we have a message. This show is about moving on and starting over. And everybody in our lives is going to have to deal with grief and loss. And we're doing that through comedy, but we're also tugging at the heartstrings. I think we're on to something with this one, really.
There we go. Final season of Ballers, HBO Now, every Sunday at 10:30 p.m. New CBS series, The Unicorn, Thursday nights, 8:30 p.m. Plus, listen to the Ozone podcast. His podcast It's all going on for Omar.
He is a busy guy.
We're talking Dodgers.
Okay, very good.
All right. Great to see you, Omar.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.